Introduction. This chapter develops the electrification of the fleet with hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, the considerations to take into account, the obstacles and the implications for fleet management. Index. Hydrogen. Hydrogen vehicles on the market. Sales of hydrogen vehicles. Electrolyzer. Efficiency of the hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. Hydrogen obstacles. Regional production potential and investment risks. Ways to produce hydrogen. The sustainability of green hydrogen. Green hydrogen production. Hydrogen station. Number of hydrogen stations in the world. The largest hydrogen station in Europe. The case of the closure of all hydrogen stations in Denmark. Repair cost. Usage problems. Fleet of hydrogen buses. EMT of Madrid. Hydrogen freight transport fleets. Implications in fleet management. Subscribe to the fleet management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Hydrogen. Hydrogen. Hydrogen is the most abundant chemical element in the universe, although it does not exist in an isolated natural state. That is, we can only find it together with other elements forming compounds, such as water or fuels. If we extract it from water, the resulting hydrogen is low carbon if it is obtained from renewable sources through a process we know as electrolysis. In it, we can separate the oxygen and hydrogen molecules. Since this process involves a large consumption of electricity, in order for the production of hydrogen to be environmentally friendly and low emission, solar or wind energy is used, especially to be able to produce the kilowatt hours that will separate the molecules of the two elements, of water, and thus obtain hydrogen in an electrolyzer. Hydrogen has numerous applications, the main ones being those we mentioned below, for the chemical industry, in the production of ammonia and fertilizers, and even for oil refining, as an energy storage system, this being one of the most important ones to give renewables the ability to manage their production, as alternative fuel, for road, sea, and air transport, as a partial substitute for methane, to produce electricity and heat in homes. Once its importance and versatility is understood, we are talking about an element that allows flexibility to the electricity network, decarbonize certain industries, and reduce dependence on external resources. Although in the last decade it has begun to have more prominence, the relationship between hydrogen and industry goes back a long way. This gas has been used as fuel since the beginning of the 19th century for cars, airships, and even spacecraft. And it is a clean energy source that only emits water vapor and leaves no residue in the air, unlike coal and oil. Some relevant physico-chemical properties of green hydrogen. The energy content per mass of hydrogen is 141.8 megajoule kilogram, a very high value, up to 3 times higher than liquid fuels based on hydrocarbons. On the other hand, hydrogen has a very low density in the gaseous state, which requires it to be compressed at high pressure or liquefied, processes of very high energy consumption. Hydrogen has high diffusivity, therefore the tanks must be very airtight to prevent leaks. Hydrogen has two great advantages in its favor. It is emission-free as long as it is obtained from renewable energy sources, allows refueling in a very short time. If we compare it with the time needed to recharge an electric car or truck battery.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as
hydrogen vehicles on the market. Passenger cars, the offer in terms of models is also quite limited. In fact, in Spain, only the Hyundai Nexo is sold, a substitute for the Hyundai 935 fuel cell. We also find the Toyota Mirai, or the Honda Clarity fuel cell that is sold in California and Japan. In addition, Mercedes-Benz already markets the GLC F-cell, which in its case is a hydrogen plug-in hybrid. In 2003, the hydrogen-powered Honda FCX went on sale. Kia also intends to enter hydrogen with a model that rivals the Nexo, although everything will depend on how the demand for this type of technology is in Europe. And while most are models belonging to Asian brands, European brands also seem to have fuel cell options in their plans. This is the case of BMW and Audi, which plan to launch their first hydrogen model on the market in 2025. Vans. Stellantis has already launched hydrogen versions of medium vans such as the Citroën Jumpy, Peugeot Expert and Opel Vivaro. In addition, it has announced that it is going to ally with Symbio, one of the large companies specializing in hydrogen fuel cell systems for vehicles. Buses. Several brands have or are developing hydrogen trucks such as Mercedes, Caetanobus or Solaris. Trucks. Several brands have or are developing hydrogen trucks such as Nikola, Hyundai, Hyzon Motors, Toyota, MAN, Volvo or General Motors is developing one together with Navistar that boasts 800 kilometers of autonomy and that will be able to refuel in 15 minutes. Public Works Machinery. Several brands such as JCB, Komatsu, Liebherr or Volvo Construction Equipment have or are developing public works or hydrogen mining vehicles such as dumpers, backhoes or excavators. Sales of hydrogen vehicles. Hydrogen cars are only 0.08% worldwide, and its sales are plummeting. In 2024, only 11,000 hydrogen cars will be on the road worldwide. Half of them are in California. In the first half of 2024, sales of hydrogen vehicles were 5,621 units worldwide. It is 34.1% less than in the same period of 2023. Hydrogen car sales peaked in 2022. The following year, in 2023, they fell by 20.7%, and the negative trend is intensifying this year. Some figures that reflect the cons of these vehicles. They are very expensive, the refueling infrastructure is very scarce, and at a technological level, they have been surpassed by battery electric vehicles. Fuel cell vehicles account for only 0.018% of new cars sold in the world, a figure that could be considered practically negligible in calculations. In the first half of 2024, 30.3 million new cars were registered in the main markets on the planet: China, Europe, the United States, India, Japan, Brazil, and Mexico. In the first half of 2024, 1.5 million battery electric cars were sold in Europe, a figure similar to the same period of the previous year. During the same time, only 594 hydrogen cars were sold, although this represented an increase of 21.5% year-on-year. Sales of hydrogen vehicles in 2024 by manufacturers. The presence of hydrogen vehicles is essentially reduced to two manufacturers. Hyundai continued to occupy first place in the global fuel cell vehicle market in the first half of 2024. It sold 1,836 units of the Nexo and the LX City, its hydrogen bus, a drop of 42.6% compared to the same period of the year. Last year, Hyundai's sales decline was mainly due to the Nexo's poor performance in its home market. Toyota sold 1,284 units, 44.9% less than last year, between the Mirai and the Crown Sedan FCEV. The latter was launched on the market last year, although only in Japan, where 384 units have been sold. In Europe, 578 Mirai units were sold, an increase of 21.5% year-on-year. On the other hand, sales of the Mirai in the United States have plummeted, with a drop of 82% year-on-year. There is another small Chinese manufacturer, Hymer, which has delivered 23 units of the Hymer 7XH, a hydrogen vehicle developed from the Hymer 7X. Electrolyzer. Electrolysis is used to produce hydrogen. Electrolysis is a chemical procedure that originates with electricity, in this case renewable, to carry out the relevant chemical reactions and break down water molecules. By applying a voltage and a direct current, dissociation reactions of molecules occur in the water, separating the oxygen that is released into the atmosphere and capturing the hydrogen. Electrolysis and the electrolyzer. The chemical reaction resulting from the electrolysis process is as follows. 2H2O2 plus 2H2. To carry out this separation, electrolyzers are devices that apply electric current to a pair of electrodes immersed in a solution. These electrodes are separated by a membrane, in which the voltage and specific intensity are applied to create an electric current that dissociates the molecules present in the water. While oxygen can be released or stored as a gas, hydrogen is stored in two ways: as liquefied gas for use in industries or fuel cells, or as compressed gas for injection into the grid. Components of an electrolyzer. An electrolyzer has various parts which we can differentiate according to their function. First of all, we find the water inlet conduit to the stack. The stack is the main equipment, a compartment where the electrochemical reaction occurs and where the water molecules will be separated into oxygen and hydrogen. It is the main equipment of the electrolyzer and requires a water management system as well as gas storage capacity, control and security. Electrolytic cells are the positive and negative separations which will create the current between an anode and a cathode. It is where the energy source is connected, in this case the electricity from a photovoltaic or wind system, when we talk about renewable hydrogen. Between the cells we find the electrolyte, a solution that has free electrons to allow current. Although the procedure is similar regardless of the technology, depending on it, we can find one type of electrolyzer or another, which will have specific reactions. However, in any of them, we will obtain oxygen and hydrogen. Types of electrolyzers. We can differentiate three main types of electrolyzers. Alkaline. Alkaline electrolyzers are the most common since their technology is the most developed. In them, a cell is composed of two electrodes immersed in an electrolyte such as potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide. When current is applied to the cells, ions circulate through the electrolyte from the positive pole to the negative pole. In this way, hydrogen appears released as a gas at the positive pole. Solid state, it is one of the most promising technologies, but it is still in a research phase and its costs are very high. These are solid systems that operate at high temperatures of the order of 600-1000 degrees Celsius, which means that there are problems with the durability of the components and their resistance to these high temperatures. Despite this, its efficiency is close to 100%, it can work at high pressures, and the system can be used as a fuel cell. PEM proton polymeric membrane. Polymeric membrane electrolyzers also have an anode and a cathode, as well as an electrocatalyst tank on them that collaborates in the chemical reaction to separate oxygen from hydrogen. The membrane functions as an electrolyte, separating gases and allowing a lot of interaction between protons, the positive charges on the nuclei of atoms. Future of electrolyzers. The biggest barrier to its promotion is the high manufacturing costs. Despite this, research and the first pilot projects are managing to progressively reduce these costs, as has happened in other industries such as photovoltaics years ago. The European plans are a great incentive to trust in its competitiveness in a few years. Europe wants to install around 40 gigawatts of electrolyzers by 2030, and Spain will play a fundamental role given that it plans to develop 10% of that amount. Being considered the energy vector of the future, green hydrogen will have an increasing presence in the energy sector, and for this, knowledge and research in the functioning and operation of electrolyzers is essential.